here. Yet, Mohammed had a mother and a father. And the Holy Quran said that Jesus was born by Mary, but not a son of God. But yet that same thing is not a son of God, it's coming back. I heard my friend Daniel Cross said, they go to the grave site. Confusion. Here, Mohammed, here, Jesus, you're not here. He's risen, as he said. This angel said, this same Jesus is coming back. Now, which Jesus they're talking about? They're talking about the Jesus that was in the beginning. Now, the Jehovah's Witness said there's two Jesus. No, there is two gods. One was Jesus who the Father made in the beginning when he said, let there be light. Paul said that, and he said, they said, Paul said, that was the beginning of creation. And God made him. Okay. If that was the light, what happened to that light? That light was divided. That was lighter. So Jesus is light? No. There is one God. One faith. One baptism. Now I'm not talking about that one God, one faith, one baptism, and water. Baptizing in water don't make you a Christian. Only thing you do, you go down a dry person. You come up a wet person. But if you accept Jesus as your Savior, all right, then you symbolize going in the ground,
yes,
and rising up again.
Yes.
I heard while they use Easter because they decided to take a heathen holiday and make it a religious holiday to get more of the heathen to come over. Some people think if you let the young people have their way, dress the way they want to dress, sing the song they want to sing, you get more people. Because I got to give it to you and give it your way. Goodbye, young people. You gone, I'm gone. I need you. You need me. You show me a church with all young people. You don't have too much of a church. See a church with all old people. You got to have the both of us.
Yes.
Got to have us so we know the way. How to know you, for you are strong.
Yes.
I cannot compete with you. We'll not try, but the same Jesus, the one that talk about his birth, Jesus was not made by God. He was not created by God. The Bible, he was the first, the last, and he blessed me and said, D-E-F-G-A all the way down to Z. And I heard that Jesus was in the beginning. I heard that everything that was made, Jesus made it. I read
thee and the woman,
uh-huh.
and between thy seed and her seed, it shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel.
Now this seed is Jesus. The first promise of a Savior. What made him greater than anybody else? A woman don't have no seed. Seed comes from a man. And only way a woman can legally, even religiously, have a baby, she must have a sexual intercourse with a man. And that way it happens. No other way did it happen. Yet the woman had no way but to adopt her seed. How can her have a seed? The same Jesus that put the seed in Adam, put that same seed in Jesus and in Mary. And she brought forth a son. Now listen. Listen,
yes.
What is so different? Up until 1986, it's somewhere in the 80s, a woman can tell was she having a boy or a girl. But some smart guy invented, he thought he invented, what they call it, ultrasound. But God had an ultrasound so far back that he wrote Jesus' birth certificate. Over 10,000 years, 10,000 years before he was born. And they shall bring forth a son. And you got to read it. He bring forth a son that is going to be Jesus. But he shall. He made a way. He didn't make no way. He saved. He didn't die just to save you. He died that you would accept him as your Savior. We were talking to Jesus, 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 thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord. Only that the Lord, I believe you died for my sin, and I will accept you. Jesus, greater than great, how dumb can the devil be? He said, I will exalt my throne above my highest. I thought my throne above the Most High. And the fool knows you can't go over the Most High. But when he wind up, I got tired already. The birth. Genesis 49. 10.
Genesis 49 and 10. The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet.
The rule, the authority,
yes.
The power don't come down from nobody but Jesus. Yes. Some people make a mistake and that's how they mess up. Say the devil don't have no power. You're stupid to believe that. If the devil don't have no power, how did Job went through the problem he did? God didn't do it, but Satan did it. And God allowed you to go through, I don't care whether it's cancer, I don't care high blood pressure, low blood pressure, God said you can go through it. But don't touch my life, high blood pressure. Hell, don't touch my life. At Bessie Gordon, the doctor says she had it in her breast. She tried to take the operation, but she skipped one. but are done by Dick the doctor.
And Jim
operated on her. Did a Blassingame. Take care of the uterus. You the Blassingame had fixed up blood clots in one leg. Did a Blassingame had blood clots in a gallbladder, something, kidney. Along. And the doctor, we got to operate. Then the thing read, Jesus stepped in and said, oh Lord, I paid the price. I buy to heal cancer. Get out of here. Don't take no operation. The doctor, you are. But let me tell you, we have to get a doctor to look at it. See, I'm blessed. Leader blessed. I'm a primary doctor. Saved. Sanctified. And got the Holy Ghost. Leader. What's that thing called for it? What does it do? Well, cancer treatment of that. It says, love God and cause. Thank you, brother. Saved, sanctified, and have the Holy Ghost. I came out of here well, but my ENT doctor is a saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost preacher. So I got Jesus as my doctor. I got Jesus as my primary doctor. I got Jesus as my ENT doctor. I got Jesus as the doctor on me. So hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus said, yes, I'm the one. All he said, They go back and tell them the Isaiah said.
Yeah.
They open the eyes of the blind. And they're being open.
Yeah.
On the ears of the deaf, they're being open.
Yeah. Read.
The dead, they're being raised. They go back and tell them, if you don't believe me, believe for my word's sake. So I tell everybody, you don't have to have faith in me, but have faith in my word. See, Jesus is the answer. He was crucified. Took the folk power. He was beat. He was scorned. He was talked about. And all that beating and all that agonizing and all that tearing through the night. They put a cross on his shoulder. And he was getting to bear the cross. And I have all the scriptures written down. But I'm not going to talk on all of them. But I tell you what happened. Some people think that Jesus got so weak. He tried to carry the cross. He couldn't. He failed. Somebody said, a black man picked up his cross and said, well, Jesus bear the cross alone, or the world go free. They were lying. That man didn't pick it up on his feet, but they made him pick up that cross. And when he picked the cross up, and why did Jesus fall? Jesus fell down to let the world see the day that was coming, long 18th blessing day. He will fall sometime. That come on a young lady, and clear foot, she's going to fall sometime. That come a young lady named Adeline Elizabeth Blassingame Coleman. She's going to fall sometime. But I heard all that to fall, but how you fall? When you fall, fall on your knees. And God will pick you up. And as he picked up that cross, and as he began to walk, I heard the songwriter picked up in his mind and said he saw Jesus walking up in Calvary. He saw Jesus had been beat all day long. And he began to holler, Calvary, Calvary, surely, surely, he died on Calvary. Set me free, set you free. I'm that tired, I can't do so. That.
Yes, Lord.
But if you're about to die in a place, he went in the ground.
Yes.
He went down.
Yes.
But he came up.
Yes.
And when he came up, he didn't come by himself. He brought some friends with him.
Yes.
They began to walk around with him.
Yes.
To speak to Jerusalem.
Yes.
I tell you, he got up.
Yes.
Early. One morning. What amazed me, the Bible said that they were watching Jesus. And after a while, a cloud came down. And he began to go up, up, and up. But one thing I like about it, Matthew read Revelation 1:7. And see, he went up. But he got to come back down. Read it.
Revelation 1:7. Behold, he cometh of clouds, and every eye shall see him.
Oh. I heard Adam Carter preach his name, but he's going to keep me in. He said that God told him, show him a vision how Jesus is coming back. He will appear on TV on worldwide TV. And that shows you how the air I can see him. But I got news for you. Air I don't watch TV in. Air I don't have a TV, whether you believe it or not. But the Bible says he's coming back. He didn't go up on TBN. He went up on a cloud. And that same Jesus, not another same Jesus, coming back on that same cloud.
Dress up like a mind.
God, I'm looking for action. Because God, I'm saying that we see him, there won't be no difference. But Jesus is looking for a pure heart, right spirit, one that accepted Christ in their life. If you have not accepted Christ, well, I've been baptized, so what? I was brought up in the church, so what? I'd rather have a church with 10 people full of church than a church full of people. So I want you, if you have not accepted Christ in your life, so I'm going to accept him today. If you accepted him, you're not walking like you should walk. The Lord, I'm going to walk this walk. I'm going to talk this talk. Things that I used to do, I'm not doing no more. I want to rededicate my life to you. Don't think that you don't have to belong to a church. If you weren't supposed to be a member of a church, God never established one. Because if they're not, the assembly was stuck together. You're supposed to assemble in the house of God. So one member told me, Brother Pat, I get more out of TV than I do home. So I told him, okay, got sick, right, wrong, indifferent. She called 18 Blassingame. 18 Blassingame, tournament, channel 48. You got more out of TV, well, call the TV. Don't call me. But I tell you one thing, that you better get it right with God. You better put your name out of there, join somebody's church. Join the church. The church of God. The church is built of pillar ground and truth. The church that teach salvation and not denomination. You got to learn how to serve God wherever you are. I had a whole lot of my sleep in that time. I'm going to tell you this. In the very time, I don't care if you're Muslim, you're women, Hindu, Buddha, Kudu, no dude. Whatever you are, if you're sincere and really love the Lord, you may be the wrong thing. But if you love the Lord, seek him. What did he say? If you seek me, you'll find me. If you seek me through Buddha, for seeking through the scriptures, and tell them the same description. And if you really love the Lord, he'll open up your eyes. He'll save you from your sin. You can't pay your way to heaven. You pray your way to heaven. I tell everybody, give your way out of debt. Pray your way out of trouble. You can pray to get in debt. Don't pray to get out of it. Get some financial advice. And the best advice finance I can give you is take 10% of the chewing gum. That money that you're spending. Take 10% and put it in God's bank. And God said he will bless you above beds. You give $100, looking for $100, you waste your time. But if you give $100, say, Lord, I give this to you. And I'm not looking for that bank. All I'm looking for is a blessing. And God will give you more than you can. I asked for $50. You can only give $1. That's all.